Yeah. They're watching it. And how do you help them in a practical way start coming out of that?
Yeah. My wife and I, we use this acronym in our household. We say, let's keep it hot. That means be honest, be open, and be transparent. God could work with your honesty, but he cannot work with your lies. And I believe the reason why so many people are bound is because they're not transparent. And to be honest with you, that's what I did with my wife.
Yeah.
I said, I want you to be honest with me. Mm-hmm. And she said, why? Because I told her, I want you to take out all the bullets out of the enemy's gun. So if we want to learn to stay pure, be full of God. Whatever you're full of is what you're going to be led by. So if you're full of yourself, then you're going to make a fool of yourself.
Oh, wow.
But if you're full of God, then you're going to be led by God. So what I would say is that after you're open, after you repent, then from there, start filling yourself up daily. Watch what you're looking at. Watch what you're looking at. For me, my favorite button right now on Instagram and social media is unfollow. Unfollow.
Yeah.
I'm gonna unfollow.
It's crazy.
You're posting some crazy photos.
Yeah.
Unfollow. You know, because whatever we look at has the potential to get into our heart, because that's where impurity starts. It starts in the eye, and then it gets to our heart.
Definitely.
So we have to make sure that we turn our eyes away from worthless things. Mm. And I love that. That's Psalm 119. God, turn my eyes away from worthless things. In other words, help me to see what you want me to see. And when those temptations come, help me to turn my eyes away from those things so it doesn't affect me.
Right.
Especially when you're going to the gym. Nowadays, I never had to pray so much before I go in the gym.
Wow.
I'm like, man, it's just getting shorter and shorter and skimpier. It's like, come on, man, this is the gym, you know? Hey, but even in the gym area, watch, you got to pray.
Yeah.
Because the enemy will always serve you a dish that you have an appetite for.
Mm.
So whatever you have an appetite for, he's going to serve you that dish. And if he's going to serve you that dish, then you need to be cognizant of what you're looking at. Mm. So those are some practical tips I would say.
I love your transparency because, you know, sometimes people think, well, he's a pastor. He doesn't struggle. He doesn't have to fight temptation. But I just appreciate your transparency.
Absolutely.
Yeah. What would you say to somebody who's watching who thinks, okay, this all sounds great.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Yeah.
But I don't think porn really affects me. I mean, I'm behind a screen. I'm not engaging in anything physical. I mean, like, what's the big deal?
Absolutely.
What would you say to them?
Yeah, porn. You know, for instance, I'll be in a practical way. If we started smoking a cigarette a day, we could easily say, smoking a cigarette doesn't affect us. Look at me. I don't have lung cancer today. I'm not getting affected today. I'm breathing well. But every time you smoke that cigarette, little by little by little, it starts to contaminate you and it starts to affect you. Same with pornography. Pornography is the small little sin that grows and grows and grows. And the Bible teaches us in the Song of Solomon that it's the little foxes that spoil the vines. So here's what pornography does. It'll start to contaminate you. Well, the reality is that when we watch pornography, we do it in our secret place. Mm-hmm. I never seen anybody tell people, hey, I'm about to watch pornography. Would you all want to hang out with me? Let's make some popcorn. Yeah. Why don't we go get the coffee ready? Because it's going to be a good video today. You know, we're not having celebration parties for pornography.
Right. Yeah.
We're doing it alone. The Bible teaches us that we should go in a secret place with God and hang out with him and get a word from him. And it's hard to be alone with God when your mind is perverted. And it's hard to lift up holy hands when you have dirty fingers.
Yeah.
The truth is that pornography will mess up your relationship with God. And then it will also mess up your marriage and start to mess up your relationships. The good news is that, hey, if you learn to repent, if you learn to give this up to the Lord and say, God, I need your help. God will help you. He will free you from this bondage. But it's us, you know, you being willing to be open and honest with God and saying, God, I need help with this.
Yeah. Now, you broke it down so well, but pornography, let's really get to, let's be honest here, it comes accompanied by something always that people don't want to talk about, the M word, masturbation. So do people need to give that up? What if people are watching, they're saying, well, but you know, like, I'm just doing that, I'm not watching pornography.
Yeah.
What would you say to them?
Yeah, well, pornography and masturbation go hand in hand. I don't know anybody who watches pornography with a coffee and whatever, a pastry, and not wanting to do anything with themselves. When it comes to masturbation, you have to think about it. So you're already in the act of sexual immorality. And that's something that I would tell the people, that you need to learn to obliterate. You need to obliterate that. You need to get rid of that, because in order to masturbate, You, even if they don't even watch pornography, we'll flip the issue up. Oh, I don't watch pornography, but I masturbate. What are you thinking about?
But you have lived it out where, yeah. I know from your testimony, you walked in purity for 7 to 8 years.
Yep, 8 years.
And you decided to not look at pornography, not masturbate.
Nope, then here's what I believe. If I'm gonna do something, if we're gonna do something, let's do it right. And I wanted my relationship with God to be genuine and I wanted it to be authentic. So I told myself, if I'm gonna have a relationship with you, God, I wanna be pure, okay? I do not wanna allow the things of this world to affect our relationship, to affect my anointing. So I abstained from it. And one book really revolutionized my life. In this book, this woman said, whenever you're struggling with those thoughts, whenever you're battling with pornography or, you know, masturbating, or if those thoughts come in, she said to do something I thought was quite interesting. She said to go and write down a list and write 10 things down that you're fighting for. Mm. So whenever those thoughts come in, you go back to your lists and you read your list and you say, okay, the reason why I'm not going to masturbate is because it's going to affect the calling on my life. The reason why I'm not going to, you know, masturbate and watch pornography, it's going to, you know, affect my leadership.
Yeah.
And when those thoughts come, because, you know, wherever we go, those thoughts are roaring rampant. You know, you go on social media, you see things, you go right outside. Like I said, you go to the gym, the mall, boom.
Yeah.
Right away. There. You know what I mean? You walk by Victoria's Secret. Mm-hmm. Here she is trying to tell you her secret. It's like everywhere you look, right? And everywhere you go, it's out there. So when those thoughts came to me, what I would do is I would go back to it. Mm.